Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls and children of God, welcome to LifeSpring Chapel, where we are a community transformed by Christ, transforming our world
with Christ.
Right. Awesome, awesome, awesome. As you can see, I'm in the garage with the beautiful Audrey, and of course, I have a guest right there, and his name is who? Talk to us, Buddha.
Jina yangu, kumajina naitwa Tony Bala, otherwise known as Tony Bala. My friends also call me Tony Bala. But you, for today, you can just call me Tony Bala.
Bala sana, bala sana, bala sana. And you can see, this is the life garage. Na kwa nini kwa garage, Buddha, ni sababu leo ni Father's Day, bro. Unajua, Father's Day lazima to represent before. As you can see, kuna vitu nyuma yangu. I don't even know what is in my father's garage, man. Budangu, I don't know. I can't remember the last time you used that. What is that? Hiyo gari inaitwa guaje?
Hii gari. Sijui kani ni Mercedes ya kitambo ama nini?
Ina kama Mercedes. Yeah,
ama ni Mustang lakini mzee. Unajua inaweza kuwa ilikuwa ndio range ya kitambo and hatujui. With a car like this they'll be like wow. Check it out kwa the newest model sasa. Hey, and iko na lights hapo mbele. Fog lights, manze.
Fog lights, Buddha. I don't know why we have a lady in the garage, because this is a man thing. Mademo wako wanafaa kwenda garage kitambo. Lakini vitu zimechange. Life imechange squeezy.
Yeah. Guys, kama wakonfirm pia, awa naume wanaenda garage kufanya nini?
Kalpa.
Jambara anasema ameenda kwa mechanic siku mzima. Eh? Unashangani kini? But I think Dano, just like that's an interesting thing. Mm-hmm. Garage kufanya nini? For me naona tu inakuanga ka man cave flani. One place enye unaweza enda ka wanaume hang out. Siwezi kuita Dano twende shopping. Itakaje sasa?
So twende garage.
I mean tutasema hata ka tunaenda kushop ya hata ka tunaenda kushop for what kwa super. It's just easier to kusema, hey, Buddha, naenda kupeleka gari yangu kuangaliwa. Wewe pia utatafuta kitu vya kuangaliwa. Ataka ni side mirror ama tire, unaona, ay, hii inakaiko hivi. Unafika hapo hivyo, then catch up to. Hapo.
Unajua kitu fani ni, I think watu bado wanaenda garage squeezy pia. Ukwesikia boy amesema nilikupeleka Moti garage lakini alikuwa ameenda ku hang out na maboy. That was the whole point, just hang out with his boys, because at some point in a life a man needs a place where they can go and, you know, get some repair. Apart from kupeleka machine it get repair, kila mwanaume anahitaji place anaweza get enda ku get repair. But I think men we hide behind, you know, the masks of you know, wealth, money, prosperity, fame, and all the successes that we have, the many children. Kitambo, I think you look at many children. So I think it is important. What do you think?
I think so too. Just like you mentioned, mask. We've got it all wrong. What another ni your masculinity na stand for mask. We find ourselves. Apo, even though you go, oh, okay, sawa basi. Masculinity, kwa the mask in masculinity is not all about wearing a mask. Yeah, I mean, we are just as vulnerable as fathers, as men, as brothers, as uncles, as guardians, just as fairer sex ladies. But at the garage, and just like you mentioned, in life, you just need to be able to undo what's been there. There could be factory settings imekam na wewe and unahitaji tu ku undo something. Maybe something happened, accident, incident on the way. And now you need to come back to the garage to check, okay, what caused this? How can you avoid next time? Sometimes it's at a cost. I mean, most of the time, even a checkup will be at a cost. The cost could be financial, it could be emotional, it could even be time-wise, but always worth it at the end.
Sure, manze. And all the things I am aware of and I know very well is just Just a minute.
Sure.
Yeah, one of the things I am aware of is, I mean, there are things that as a man we need to think about. That thing of having men that you can be vulnerable to is very key. I think it's wrong to feel like you can do it by yourself. And I want to salute every man who have you know, supported me, every man who have a community or a mbogi where they go and get their machines, you know, done or oiled. Salute. Nini watu wa maana. But welcome to LifeSpring Chapel. And Tony will be talking about that in a minute. But I just want to introduce to you to, you know, a life community that has so many men that know where the garage is. And these men lead different things. For example, we have MAST. MAST is our men fellowship. And MAST stands for Men Are Strong Towers. Cindy or Tony?
Yes, sir.
Yes, and of course we have the youth ministry. We have so many things. We have the children ministry. On Sunday we call it the Kids City, but on Friday we have Bible Club. We have the Move. We have Cafe. We have Club Life. We have Wash. But you know, Wash is not possible without MAST. Did you know that?
That's true.
Wash is not possible without MAST. So, because men are strong towers. I needed to just slide that in somewhere. It will be so hard, or it will be so bad for me to invite you up on stage. Even before kabla niseme joke hapa hivi, somebody says, a science teacher asks, when is the boiling point reached? So a science teacher is asking a student, so when is the boiling point reached? And then the student said, when my dad sees my report card.
That's when the dad sees the report card, it's either...
It's 10 hours.
Or, wondering, yeah. What did you get here?
You tell me a kuchemka. But as I invite you on stage, because I see it's time to go to join the community, I want to read something here and just encourage everybody out there, maybe who's hearing our stories and feeling, I've never had a dad, man. So mnongea kuhusu nini? I want to introduce the good father. He is a good, good, good father. And this is what the Bible says in Psalm chapter 68. Psalm 68 and verse 5, the Bible says, Father, to the... I will sing from verse four. It's a song. Sing praises to God and to his name. Sing loud praises to him who rides the clouds. His name is the Lord. Rejoice in his presence. Father to the fatherless, defender of widows. This is God whose dwelling is holy. Thank you very much for joining our, behind us, or our backstage conversations. My name is Hype Dante, joined by Audrey, and let me introduce to you Tony Balabala to tell us what we have to say.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dano. So welcome all to today's service. Thank you so much for joining in. And just got a snippet of what happens live backstage. I'd like to welcome you all to LifeSpring Chapel, where we are a community transformed by Christ, transforming our world with Christ. Now, I'd like to remind you all, for those who are on Facebook, karibuni sana. Feel free to engage in the comment section. Feel free to just interact with us. Tell us where you're from, how you're feeling, and we'll be able to also interact, find out from you how you are, and even just how the service is for you. For those on Zoom, karibuni sana. Just a reminder to keep your mic muted as we go on with the service so that we can be able to hear each other out as well. And we just like to, again, One last time, welcome you all to LifeSpring Chapel. Together, I want to say with Dano, karibuni sana,
and
happy Father's Day.
Wow.
Indeed, our God is an awesome God. Amen. And we are here just to call him Yahweh, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. How many believe with me that God is able? Amen. How many believe with me that God ni mshindi wa washindi? Come on, give it a shout of praise. And
nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi? Kama yawe mshindi wa washindi? Nani kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
Kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu, oh, hakuna mwingine kama Ndio maana tunasema
mwingine chini na juu, oh, kuna mwingine kama yawe.
Ndio maana tunasifu
mwingine chini na juu, oh, kuna mwingine kama yawe.
Nani kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
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 Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu, oh, kuna mwingine kama yawe. Ndio maana tunasema chini na juu, oh, kuna mwingine kama yawe. Ndio maana tunasifu chini na juu, oh, kuna mwingine kama yawe. Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Nani kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
Nani kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Nani
kama yawe mshindi wa washindi? Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu, oh, hakuna mwingine kama yawe. Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu, oh, hakuna mwingine kama yawe. Ndio maana tunasema chini na juu, oh, hakuna mwingine kama yawe. Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi? Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
Nani kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
Nani kama yawe mfalme wa wafalme?
Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu, kuna mwingine kama yawe. Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu, kuna mwingine kama yawe. Ndio maana tunasema chini na juu, kuna mwingine kama yawe. Nani kama yawe mshindi wa washindi?
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 Ndio maana tunaimba chini na juu,
kuna mwingine kama yawe.
Ndio maana tunasema chini na juu, kuna mwingine kama yawe.
To welcome you to a time of worship, we ask that you ask the Holy Spirit to search your soul, look into your heart, bring out the issues inside of you, to just reconnect with you as we worship the Lord in spirit.
Miracle worker,
You are a miracle worker. Come and do your miracle, your miracle today. Come and do your miracle today. Miracle worker, you are a miracle worker. Come and do your miracles today. Yes, you do your miracles today. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You're a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You're a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You're a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Promises keeper, you are a promises keeper. Come and keep thy promises today. Yes, you keep your promises today. Your name is Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. Working God, your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You're a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. 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 You're a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh. Indeed, we thank God because He does the things that not even human beings can understand. No one can fathom. We thank Him for being so awesome, so magnificent.
Unafanya mambo ambayo wanadamu hawezi kufanya. Unatoa faraja ambayo wanadamu hawezi kutoa. Haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Oh, haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Say wewe ni Mungu, utuliza mawimbi. Haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Wewe ni Mungu, upasua bahari. Haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Unafanya mambo ambayo mwanadamu hawezi kufanya. Unatoa faraja ambayo mwanadamu hawezi kutoa. Haufananishwi na kitu kingine. Oh, haufananishwi bowing me. How fun and nisi na kitu kingine. Wewe ni Mungu upasua bahari. How fun and nisi na kitu kingine. Unafanya mambo ambayo wanadamu hawezi kufanya. Unatoa faraja ambayo wanadamu hawezi kutoa. How fun and easy, na kitu kingine. Unafanya mambo ambayo wanadamu hawezi kufanya. Unatoa faraja ambayo wanadamu hawezi kutoa.
Thank you very much for being with us there. Allow me to invite Pastor Sue, who will be coming to lead us with a word of prayer right now. Susan, take it away.
Good morning, everyone. I'll read from Psalm chapter 97, a song of praise to the sovereign Lord. The Lord reigns, let the earth rejoice, let the multitude of Eiffel be glad. Clouds and darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. A fire goes before him and burns up his enemies round about. His lightnings light the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax at the presence of the Lord. At the presence of the Lord of the whole earth, the heavens declare his righteousness, and all the people see his glory. Let all be put to shame who serve carved images, who boast of idols. Worship him, all you gods. Zion hears and is glad, and the daughters of Judah rejoice because of your judgments, O Lord. For you, Lord, are most high above all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. You who love the Lord hate evil. He preserves the souls of his saints. He delivers them out of the hand of the wicked. Light is sown for the righteous and gladness for the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holy name. Heavenly Father, we are grateful this morning for your love. We thank you that your God who reigns over all the earth, your God who reigns now and forever, you are the Alpha and the Omega. You're the beginning and the end, and we worship you this morning. Lord, we exalt you above all the earth. We are grateful that you have gathered us here this morning and taken care of us throughout the week. We are grateful, Lord, for everyone that is joining us this morning, that you know where they are at, you know their needs, you know their thanksgiving, and we're truly grateful. Father, we just want to worship you this morning. And Lord, as we have sung, that there is none like you. You alone are King of Kings, you are Lord. You alone are Lord of Lords. We are thankful, Lord, as we come this morning and as we continue to study through your word, O God, and even as we are in the final chapters of Revelation this morning, learning about the things that you spoke to John. And we thank you that you've said that your word your words are true and that they are faithful. And Lord, we declare that you are the beginning and you're the end. You're the one who reigns over all the earth. And indeed, we look forward to the day that we shall be united with you forever, dwelling with you in the new heaven and in the new earth forever and ever. And Lord, even as we live this life, we pray that, Lord, you would deliver us from evil, that, Lord, you would keep us from sin, even as we look forward to the time where there will be no more sin, to the time where there will be no more death, no more pain. We ask that, Lord, as we walk through this journey, that you would sustain us, that you protect us, that you'd help us to keep hope alive in every season of our lives, even in this time. Many people are going through a difficult time in this pandemic season, but we ask that, Lord, you shall keep us encouraged. You shall keep us focused on you and on your word that is true and faithful. On you, O God, who never changes. You're the same yesterday, you're the same today, you'll be the same forevermore. We thank you for life being as a church. We're truly grateful that you've enabled us to meet every single Sunday online. We thank you for providing this platform for us, that we can come together and fellowship, encourage one another, hear your word, O God. And Lord, how faithful you are, that, Lord, we have finally come to the end of Revelation, that we have studied Revelation from beginning to the end, O God. And we pray that, Lord, as we listen to these words and as we have listened, that, Lord, they would remain in our hearts, that we would know who we truly are, who you say we are, and who we shall be at the end of it, Lord. We thank you that in you we have confidence. We thank you that in you we have hope, hope that is everlasting, hope that is never fading. Lord, we thank you this morning for each one of us as we come to you and as we listen to your word, that you'd speak to our hearts. We pray for the preacher for the day and ask that you'd speak through him or her, that, Lord, you'd use them for your glory. I am to thank you this morning as we celebrate Father's Day. We are truly grateful for the fathers in our midst, for our own fathers. And Lord, we thank you that you who is our Father, our Heavenly Father, are the one that we look to every day. We pray for the fathers in our midst, that, Lord, you continue to lead them and to guide them on how to be good parents to their children. We ask that your blessings will be upon them. We ask that you provide for everything that they need to be outstanding fathers. Lord Jesus, we just commit ourselves and our lives to you, each one of us, Lord, wherever we are joining in from. We ask that, Lord, you'd meet us at our points of need. Lord, if there's anyone who is sick in our midst, we ask that you reach out to them and heal them. We ask for your provision for those who need provision. We ask that you sustain us, Lord, in everything that we do. We pray that you bless the work of our hands, our job, our businesses, and every endeavor that we have. Thank you for our pastors that have diligently prepared for us every Sunday and even throughout the week. We ask that you bless them and reward them greatly. And we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
John saw a city that could not be hid. John saw the city. Oh, yes, he did. John caught a glimpse of the golden throne. Tell me all about it. Go right on around the throne. He saw the crystal sea. There's got to be more. What will it be? I want to go to that city he saw. New Jerusalem, I want to walk your streets that are golden, and I want to run where the angels that drown. Jerusalem, I want to rest on the banks of your river. In that city, city of God. John saw the lion lay down by the lamb. I want to know everything about that lamb. John saw the day but did not see night. The Lamb of God, well, must be the light. He saw the saints worship the great I Am, crying worthy, worthy is the Lamb. I want to go to the city he saw, New Jerusalem. I want to walk your streets that are golden, and I want to run where the angels can fly.
Or is it Revelation finale? Whatever we want to call it, but it excites me to be doing this. Good morning, church. It's good to be here. I'm glad to be sharing with us Revelation chapters 21 and 22, the last chapters of the Bible. It's Bible finale, or is it Revelation finale? Whatever we want to call it, but it excites me to be doing this today. My name is Harriet. I pastor the children's church. I am grateful. I think what excites me is that the contents of these 21 and 22 chapters of Revelation also talks about the world's finale. There is a day that will come when everything in the world will come to an end. The world as we know it and the systems of the world will come to an end one day. Jesus said in Luke chapter 21 and verse 33, everything will pass away except his word. And this is what John saw. John saw a new heaven and a new earth, because the old heaven and the old earth and passed away. Even the sea was no more. I don't know whether you have heard of this statement that people used to make a while ago, that you have become so heavenly minded that you are of no earthly good. I heard that statement sometime. It was being used to talk to or to as a sarcasm to people that were so spiritual, people that were so much into the things of God that they looked like they don't care about everyday life. And they used to be told, you guys, you become so heavenly minded that you are not of any earthly good. And I think in the days that we are living today, we live the opposite of that statement. We have become so earthly minded that we have sometimes lost our sight of the fact that there is a day that is coming, and it is now nearer than when we first believed, when the world and all its systems will come to an end. Jesus said in one of the Gospels that do not store up all your wealth, all your time and treasure and talent where moth, rust, and thieves can have access, because there is something greater than our earthly investments. There is something greater than the life that we live on earth. And I want us to reflect about the life that we live today. Are we living as if everything is ending with this world? Are we putting all our time, all our treasure, and all our talent in the systems of the world that are passing away? Are we living in sight of the fact that one day we will stand before the Lord and give an account of how we have lived our lives? And now John says that he saw this city, the heavenly Jerusalem, the city that God has prepared for his people, descend from heaven. I took notice of that the new Jerusalem descended from heaven. It is not the saints that ascended to the heaven, but Jerusalem descended to them. And I thought about it and realized, I think this is what God did even in the time when Jesus came for our salvation. It looks like we cannot ascend to God. We cannot be able to do anything human that can get us near God. We cannot achieve righteousness or a state of being right with God by our own human deeds. God descends. He descends to bring us salvation. He descends to bring us deliverance. And he will descend. His Jerusalem will descend to us, because salvation is a matter of faith in Jesus. We receive it as a gift. So will we receive even this new Jerusalem by faith. It's not something we can achieve by our own doing. So John goes on to say, or to describe to us, the beauty of this city. He says that the streets were of gold. He talks about a building that is 12 coarse precious stone. He talks about all the names of the stones that were used in building this city, spectacular, glorious city that he could not finish to describe. Indeed, he says he could only tell us it looks like. He could only use a simile or a metaphor to tell us it was as clear as crystal. It was as pure as gold, because he could not fully describe. I think what he is saying, that the city is indescribable. He cannot be able to fully tell us what it looks like. Maybe it is what Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 9, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has comprehended what God has prepared for those who love him. It is wonderful. It's great. It's a great city. And then he talks about how he saw God himself wiping the tears of the saints. And in fact, the Bible says that God himself wiped every tear. I took notice of the word every. It looks like God notices all types of tears that his children shed. Maybe tears of loss, tears of rejection and persecution, tears of lack and toil. Whatever is it that causes you tears, the Bible says that God will wipe away every tear from the eyes of the saints. It will be a time when God dwells together with his people. You know, John Lekoden says that there will be no temple in heaven. There will be no need for a temple, because the use of the temple will have come to the end. God himself shall be dwelling among his children. You remember the story of Jesus with the Samaritan woman at the well, where, who was stuck. The woman was stuck at, where do we worship? Should it be at the mountain or is it in Jerusalem, the temple? Where is the right place for worship? And Jesus said, it's not about where we worship. It is about who we worship. He said, the one we worship is a spirit, and we worship him in truth and in the spirit. We worship him in genuineness. We worship him in the power of the Holy Spirit. We were believing this moment that Jesus was describing. In fact, he told the woman even that time, the time has come, is coming, and the time has come that those who worship God shall worship him in truth and in the spirit. That time, it will be so perfect that we will not even need the temple. God himself will dwell among his people. I think what makes heaven heaven is the presence of God, because the presence of God changes everything. There will be no need for light, the Bible says, because the sun and the moon will not be necessary. Jesus will be the light of this city. You know, the Bible says in Psalms 139 that even darkness is not dark to God. I don't know what is it that is so dark to you, what situation that seems to you so dark and desperate, and God says even darkness is not dark to him. There will be no need for light in heaven, because Jesus will be the light of that city. And John goes on to describe the measurements of this city. He says that it was a square, at least according to how we saw, it was a square, and it was 1,400 miles in measurements. The Bible says, according to the standards, the human standard used by the angel, it was 1,400 miles length and width. Now, I have heard some people say that God has already predestined the people who will go to the New Jerusalem. I don't know whether those miles are small or many according to them, but I choose to believe what Jesus said in John chapter 14. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. And the Bible assures us that there is enough room for all the people whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. For everyone whose robe has been washed in the blood of Jesus, there is enough room. That is what Jesus said. He's going to prepare a place, and this place shall be enough for all the people whose names have been written in the Lamb's Book of Life. So this city is the one whose architect and builder is God himself. I think this is what the heroes of faith in Hebrews chapter 11 had seen. The Bible says they were able to persevere all the challenges and the persecutions of their time because their eyes were looking forward to a city whose architect and builder is God himself. I want to be in that city someday. I want to be among the number when the Lord calls on the people who will enter there. It says that it was built on foundation of stones inlaid with 12 precious stones. It names them, and it says that the gates of this city, which are 12 in number, that they are in the square, three gates on each side, and says that the gates had the names of the 12 tribes of Israel written on them. Also, the foundations of the city had the names of the apostles of the Lamb written on them. And I think this is just to mean that the city that Christ Jesus has prepared for his bride is a place where the groom, Christ Jesus, has prepared for his bride, is inclusive of all the New Testament believers and the Old Testament believers, because the Old Testament believers identified themselves with the 12 tribes of Israel. So the names of the 12 tribes are written on the doors of the gates of heaven, and the foundations also bear the names of the apostles. And I think that the Bible says that the foundations of our faith is founded on the foundations of the prophets and the apostles, Jesus himself being the cornerstone. This means that everyone has been factored. All the people that have put their faith in Jesus have been factored either in the Old Testament, though they didn't know Jesus the way we know him, and in the New Testament, everyone has been counted. In fact, the Bible says that all the tribes and tongues will be present in the New Jerusalem. Now, when John's the other thing that John saw in heaven was a river. The river of life. That is what the Bible calls it. He saw the river of life. He also saw a tree that was growing alongside the river. And this tree was giving a fruit every month. And the people were allowed to eat from the tree of life. And it says that also they were allowed to drink from the river of life. And the trees of the leaves of the tree were used for the healing of the nations. And I wondered, of course, this also means the tree of life that Adam and Eve were forbidden from eating when they sinned against God is now available, and people are allowed to eat from it, and they are allowed to be refreshed by the river of God, the river of life. Wherever this river goes, it refreshes. Isaiah talked about it in Isaiah chapter 55 and verse 1. It says, come and drink. Come, all you are thirsty. Come to the water. And you who have no money, come, buy and eat. Buy wine and milk without money and without a cost. That is the river of our God. It says, come. Those who are thirsty, God refreshes them. And in the story that I alluded to earlier, Jesus tells the Samaritan woman in John chapter 4, whoever drinks this water that I am giving you, inside of them, there shall be a spring of living water. This is what Jesus gives when he comes to him, a refreshing source of water, a refreshing river that flows from the throne of God. I want to pray today that God will give us an experience of refreshment, an experience of that comes from the river of God, because that river is flowing. That river is not only for the future. John saw it in that time that the river of God exists. Jesus talked about it. Isaiah is talking about it. There is a river of God that is available for your refreshing even today. And you can drink from the river of God. You can ask the Lord to refresh you. I don't know where and what is thirsting and where you're feeling downcast and beaten by the sun. The Lord is inviting you for a river that is refreshing. And I'm excited about the fruit that we will be allowed to eat. This fruit that Adam and Eve could not eat. The Bible says in Genesis that God put an angel to forbid them from going back to the garden, but God makes it available for all those who manage to get to the city of God, the fruit of God. It will be wonderful to eat the fruit of God, the fruit of life, the Bible calls it. Now, sometimes we blame Adam and we are like, okay, we wish he did not sin. We wish we stayed in Eden and we did not get cast out and the ground was not cast and all these things that happened with the sin did not happen. But the story in Revelation 21 and 22 shows us that what we have in Christ Jesus is far greater than what we could have achieved by the innocence of Adam. Jesus has brought us something greater than what we would have gotten if we stayed without the sin. Not to justify the sin of Adam, not to say that it was good that they sinned, but to say that God works for good in all things. He knows how to bring out good in all things. He has worked a better plan. Jesus has brought us something greater and more glorious than what Adam would have achieved in Eden. It is John Piper who says the redeemed man is greater than Adam. So I am excited about what Jesus has done. There are no regrets about what Adam did, because Jesus has brought us to a more glorious experience with God, to a new city, the Jerusalem of God. Now, there are people who have said that they will not enter this city, where even the curse will not be upon the land anymore. It will have been taken away. It will be perfect. And the people of God will bear the name of God on their forehead. What is it to Lisoma Uku, Revelation about 666? The people of God will bear the name of God himself on their forehead. And the Bible talks about one thing that will not enter heaven. And he is very serious about it. Sin. Sin will not enter heaven. The cowards, the people who would rather preserve themselves and their security than profess Christ, the unbelievers, those who have rejected salvation, the murderers, the magicians, the idol worshippers, all those, and the Bible says that they will have no place in heaven. Theirs will be outside the city with the dogs and into the fiery lake of fire. I once heard a Kikuyu song that says the dogs will be wondering and the dogs will be asking these people a question. You guys, why are you out here with us and someone died for you? For us dogs, we are here because nobody died for us. And I don't want any one of us to be asked such a question by the dogs. I thought about this for us who are believers, for us who have put our faith in Christ. It would be so sad to miss this day. It would be like a bride who misses their own wedding, because it will be the day of the wedding for the Lamb and the church. If you are a child of God, you have believed in Jesus all these days, and you, somehow you stop being serious about your walk with Jesus. The Bible says, oh, what sadness, what a sad day that would be if we would be left. It would be like a bride who misses their own wedding, or an athlete who starts the race, but they don't get to the finish line. I want to encourage us to put our faith on Jesus, to put our faith on the finish line, to put our faith on that day when Jesus is coming, so that we are not left out, so that we are not like the virgins who ran out of fuel when the groom was just about to come. So I want us to pray and ask the Lord to keep our eyes on focus. Ask the Lord to keep us believing, to keep us in the faith, to protect us and to help us so that we are ready when the Lord Jesus comes. I don't know what comes to your mind as you think about the Lord's second coming. The Bible says no one knows the day or the hour. It could be any time, could be any day, but soon and very soon, we will hear the shouts of the angel and the trumpet, and the Lamb will be here. Let's pray. Father Lord, we thank you for your word. We thank you that you have promised to come. You promised to take us to be where you are. It is your word, and it will come to be. The Bible says you told John to write these things because they are trustworthy and they will surely happen. Lord, we pray and ask from you that you would continually help us to remember that you have bought us from the world, that you have bought us from the systems of the world, and you have given us your great salvation. I pray that when you come, we will be ready. When you come, O Lord, our clothes will still be pure. The garments will be pure, O God. Our names will be on the Lamb's Book of Life that day. We will be ready. We will be ready when you return. I pray that none of us will be left. None of us will have looked back. None of us will have regretted salvation. But Lord, we will be looking forward to that day like the heroes of faith. We'll have our eyes fixed on Jesus until when he comes. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor Harriet, for just that message. It's exciting when you come to the grand finale. It's exciting, even for us who have been studying through the book of Revelation, and we are feeling, wow, you know, just the treasures that have been unveiled through that that book of the Bible. The book that when we were starting off, we said, you know, it's not intended to scare you. It is not intended to be seen as a code to be cracked, but instead, when you open yourself to the Spirit, then the Spirit will reveal these truths. And I'm hoping that for many of us, this book has become clearer. You have found the blessing, because it says very early on that there are blessings in this book. And as you have opened, you have found blessings. But also, for those who may not have started, you know, we have all these recorded, and you can go start on from the beginning and just follow through. But that today, there's that picture that Pastor Harriet has so clearly painted for us, you know, the picture of that which we long for. You know, it's a picture of abundance. It's a picture of healing. It's a picture of light, you know, where there is no darkness. It's a, because the light comes from the one who sits on the throne. You know, that it's a picture that speaks about, you know, just the fullness of what God has intended. And I'm just thinking, wow. Pastor Harriet is here. And if you're there and you have a question for her, you can type it in the comments, and we will get her to respond to that question. I don't know if Pastor Harriet, you can hear us. Thank you. Thank you for such a wonderful message that you have brought to us. I don't know what it has meant. It meant for you to prepare to bring this word. You know, maybe just tell us briefly what that meant.
Well, it was exciting to read and to listen to the Spirit of God. I was just excited about the fact that these things are true. There are things we read, and sometimes it looks to us like it is not true. But the angel told John to write. In fact, in chapters 21 and 22, John saw the beauty of the city and forgot to write.
I think so your connection is unstable. We cannot hear clearly what you are saying. Has gone off as well.
Okay.
I don't know. Just keep talking. We'll pick out whatever it is that you need to pick out from the conversation.
I'm saying John had actually forgotten to write because he was puzzled by the beauty of the city, and the angel had to remind him, John, write. Mm-hmm. These things will be true and they will happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think I would forget to write if I was so mesmerized by all the things that are being revealed to me. I would forget to write things like those. But it's interesting that you say, you know, the angel reminded him. Because what if he had not written? You know, the angel knew the importance of putting this book down, and reminded him to just pen it down so that those who are coming later would find encouragement in this. Imagine if we were living this life of faith with no clarity as to what the end looks like. It's like, you know, watching the Premier League and not knowing when it's going to end, the season is going to end. You know, it will lose its purpose and its meaning, okay? But then in the context of today, you know, I can see people are signing up and sending comments. Mte, thank you from Arusha, good friend. From Arusha, thank you for following us today. But people like Mte and others are fathers today, you know. And the Revelation grand finale, how does it mesh together with the picture of the good father? Maybe you can help us just briefly see the connection there.
Oh, yeah. Our father is so caring that he did not leave us in our sin. He did not abandon us at the Garden of Eden, but he went all the way to come and bring us a better thing, even with all our sin, with all our deserving. You saw, it says that Jerusalem descended. The Father knows we can't go where he is. He comes. Mm-hmm, he comes to us, and he is willing to embrace us, to wash us, and to give us a city despite of our sinfulness.
That was a very interesting perspective, Pastor Harriet. I've read that portion of scripture, but I have not seen, you know, just the gift that the New Jerusalem is to his people. You know, that it descends. It's like a gift that is given to his people. And there are gifts that our fathers give us. But I think it also delights the Father when we give him gifts. And I'm saying this, yeah. maybe this only happens to fathers of girls. I don't know about fathers of boys like Gama. You're a mother of Gama. I don't know about, but
Jeffrey.
You know, yeah. But this is what the girls do. They give you gifts. And I hadn't opened these gifts. And I could see on their eyes, they are eager to see me open. So yes, Zuri, they're probably watching, and Imani, thank you for these gifts. And there are things written in there, you know, I love you, Dad, because you are Dad. You know, and I do not
fear if you are. I do not. Okay.
Yeah, you see, only the fathers can understand that language. But I don't know about fathers out there. Have you received notes? I can see George is watching from Nairobi West. George, I know, has a daughter, Leah. And you can compare between the love of the son, sons, and the love of the daughter. But this is from Imani. Thank you, Imani. You know, happy Father's Day to you. Thanks for being our dad. I love you. You know, this is Imani, your second born child. And there's so, you know, kisses and stuff like that.
And all the different names of fathers.
Oh, wow.
Now, pop, pa, pabi, old man, tata, yeba, vada. I think she did some internet research.
Wow. Yes. So, maybe just to tie it together, is just to see that, you know, fathers give you gifts as children, okay? But it delights the father also to receive the gifts. And, you know, the best and greatest gift is for the father to know that he can dwell with his children for eternity. And how do you do that, you know? You do that through, repentance. Because scripture tells us that when we repent, if you're wondering, how do I get to spend time or to long for the new Jerusalem? It's through repentance. Scripture says, you know, when you repent, the Lord is faithful and just to forgive you and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Because unrighteousness is what separates the holy from the unholy, you know. And when he cleanses us of all unrighteousness, then we are made holy. Thank you so much, Pastor Harriet. I don't know if you have one last parting shot, maybe a thought that has come before we go to the next segment.
I would say the gift that would please the Father today is for you to receive what he has already offered you.
Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Harriet. We look forward to hearing you teach more at other times, but I know where your favorite space of teaching is. For those who have children, Pastor Harriet is our children's pastor, and every week there is content, good, wholesome content for children. If you want that content, she can send it to you on YouTube, you know, but also we have it on the LifeSpring Chapel pages. So thank you so much, Pastor Harriet. See you again next time.
Thank you.
All these stories about fathers are, I feel like I might go off on a track, but this morning we had an opportunity to pray for fathers in our community. Fathers, those who've been fathers for a long time, those who are indifferent, are dealing with their fatherhoods in different ways. And we pray that if you're here, and the Lord is working with you in an aspect of fatherhood, that you would find grace from God, that you would find peace, and the power that comes from the Holy Spirit, to occupy the duty and the space of being a father. So we celebrate you, fathers, at LifeSpring. Happy Father's Day. And we are glad that you're joining us from wherever you are. Kelly Pengo, thank you for joining us. And may God bless you as we continue to fellowship. As we continue to worship, as we think about giving, the thing that I thought about today as we come to give is that Jesus is the only person who revealed God as a father. none of the prophets were able to reveal him as a father. And Jesus revealed him as a father to us. And as we come to the Father today, how do we come? And I thought the most appropriate way for us to come to the Father today, one is to receive. When we come to a Father, we receive. I don't know a Father where you go and you don't receive. When you give him, ni kama anakurudishia na kupatia even more. So today I'd like us to encourage us to come to our time of giving with thanksgiving. The psalm that Susan read today during the pastoral prayer time is that the Lord, the Most High, is over all the earth. That's your heavenly Father. He is exalted above all gods. He loves you. He guards the lives of his faithful ones. He delivers them from the hand of the wicked. Light is shed upon the righteous and joy on the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in your Father, you who are righteous, and praise his holy name. And for me, the message for giving is just that simple. We come to a Father who loves us. Let's come in thanksgiving. Let's come in worship and just be and sit and enjoy his presence. The options for giving are going to be shared. You can give through M-Pesa, Paybill, 805-100-805-100. And if you're writing a check, it's in favor of Light Spring Chapel. Let's pray as we come to a time of giving. Lord, we come to you with thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for revealing yourself as a Father. Thank you, Lord, for filling a void that was obviously there. And Lord, we pray in thanksgiving that, Lord, you have raised the standard. And we pray for ourselves that, Lord, we will not be caught up in how much we are not able to meet that standard, but that, Lord, we will be consumed in how good you are as a Father, how good you are to care for us, how good you are to protect us, how good you are to secure us, to secure a lot for us, to give us an inheritance that can never perish, spoil, or fade, to bring us close to you, to remove any barrier that, Lord, before you there is no Jew, there is no Gentile, before you there is no black and white, but that, Lord, through your Spirit, you make us into your children. You have given us your Spirit, and by your Spirit, we cry out, Abba, Father. So, Lord, we continue to cry out to you. We continue to thank you for choosing to bring us close to you. Thank you for allowing us to be those that will be part of that heavenly chorus of singing, Holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. The earth is full of his glory. Lord, receive the gifts that we bring today. Receive them. May they bring you joy. May they please you, O God. May the work that is done through the gifts that are given to today glorify your name. May your name be magnified and be manifested wherever these gifts go, wherever these resources are used. May your name be glorified, your name and your name only. We give you glory. We give you honor. Thank you, Lord. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen and amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Nzisa, Pastor Maish. Hamjambo.
Hatujambo. Hatujambo.
When you're talking to your dad, lazima uweke heshima kidogo. So, Pastor Maish, happy Father's Day. I know I had done this earlier. Lazima niambia watu, nilikuraukia. And I hope you are having a good day. Mtei says, happy Father's Day. I am here to also read some of those comments. And as you can see, I'm in the garage. I started here with Tony Bala, a little bit things about our fathers. And I'm so excited to know that the best father in the world is actually my dad. All right. But also,
I'm wondering whether it's me. The connection is choppy. For those who are watching, I hope it's clear for you. Maybe it's just me. But I did not hear what you said. I just had one or two things I remember, and that's it.
All right, that was a dad joke. Pastor Maishi, if I'm not clear, I want to ask you to carry on. And what we are doing here is kwaheri. So you help me. If I'm breaking, kindly help me say kwaheri to the online people. But also, please, salimia wale watu wamekuwa wakiwatch, and you can highlight their comments as we go.
All right. I don't know if Pastor Harriet, you're live with us. I don't know if you heard what Dante was saying. Maybe you can help us. But what I picked out was, Pastor Harriet, did I lose you again? What I picked out was that he's asking that we help him say kwaheri to those who have been watching. Maybe you can join in and say kwaheri to people. I can see Mili, Teacher Mili, good to see you there. Thank you for joining us. I can see Kelly and Emily. Good that you can join us from the winter world. Anyone you want to give shout outs to, Pastor Harriet, as we close?
Well, I can see Mtei. I can see Purity, Nancy, Sete. I don't know whether I read that correctly, but I want to thank you for joining. It's good to have you here. Mm. Harry.
All right. Thank you so much. May the Lord bless you. Allow me to just share just a blessing upon you to all who are watching, wherever you are at. May the Lord bless you with his presence, as it is said in the book of Revelation. May he make his dwelling amongst you as his people. May he provide for you. May he supply for all your needs. That yes, there are stories out there and testaments of what could be possible, but those who are in the Lord are protected. May he protect you. May those who desire healing for themselves or for people who are in their family who are not well, Lord, I want to speak healing upon their lives right now in the name of Jesus. May we enjoy your shalom, which comes with abundance, with good health, and with your presence, O Lord Jesus. In all these things, be glorified. For it is in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, we pray and believe.
Amen.
And
amen.
Join me in saying amen.
Amen.
And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all and with us now and forevermore. Amen. 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 Amen.